So, back on it. Had to do this right quick. So, The Jeffersons was actually a very forward-thinking sitcom from back in the day. Now, I have no clips really about the show. It was a host in the show, and they knew how to write shows back then of, you know, just black successful men. And it wasn't to try to shit on everyday working black men. It was just showing the struggles that some black people had on different levels. It's the difference between that and shows like Good Times, and there are actually a few shows where they were hardworking black men, but they weren't rich. But this is one of the shows where it was a rich black man, or well-doing black man. And when it came to a lot of subjects they covered, it was hugely forward-thinking. One of the things in particular that I'm going to get on and talk about is that one of the forward-thinking subjects that they covered, because we, as black people, always have to cover this when it comes to our shows and talking about these types of things, is a relationship that happened in marriage. Okay, I don't think I'm going to find a clip because I actually forgot his name, but one of the children... daughters actually dated a man who was white. And again, this happened faster in black media, and this happened faster with black people, mostly in charge of shows. This is the thing where I don't understand why they try to shift around the rhetoric, especially on the left, to try to make black people accountable when we've made strides for other communities. But we've been talking about this dating from before. One of the things is, if you notice in a lot of shows, because it's not that hard to see, but they also try to make it subtle and seem healthy and not as noticeable, is when any other race, including white men, date black women. And I've seen it littered throughout. And it's this thing where you constantly see where if it's a black man dating out, it's really not bad. Consider Tyler Perry and his words. Anytime a black man considers lighter, he's evil. He's evil for dating lighter and stuff like that. And it even goes to the TV shows. I can get tedious with that, but for now, I'm just talking about it. But you see in the shows where, again, if it's a black man and a white man, it's a good thing. It's a good thing. It's a great thing. It's a fantastic thing. In fact, if you not being okay with it means you're racist. It's the same rhetoric that's out there. And the question that a lot of these people are asking is, like, if it's okay and acceptable and it's the lesson we have to learn, then why is it not that they've accepted it on reciprocity? And that's because this wasn't a compromise. This was never a compromise. It was always going to be a balance, utilizing and taking advantage of that. Oh, yeah, this relationship right here. Yeah, because it's still a problem to this day. Now, don't get me wrong, it's not that black men don't date out, but normally they're indoctrinated into their ways. There's more freedom oftentimes whenever, if you notice, whenever there's a black woman white man relationship, or whenever there's a black man white woman relationship, either the black man is indoctrinated into conservative or public ways. You'll notice that with the justices and even on the Supreme Court, when you compare the different people. Now, I'm not saying that black men don't do some conservative things, no. I'm admitting that when it comes to household and how things are run, oftentimes the black people are convinced, or the black men are convinced or indoctrinated into their ways. And they go hard. They go hard for the Republicans, hard for the conservatives, they go hard for them in their way of life. That really doesn't break you. Well, just work for people who are black. Because let's consider this conservative BS. Let's go back to the Book of Clotel, the daughter of Andrew Jackson. In that book, one of the reasons why I think it's not a lot of libraries is because it does talk about black women being exploited for sex. I mean, at the end of the day, Clotel does want to be married to a guy who's white because she wants to be saved from the cycle of slavery and things of that nature. True. However, it does talk about those types of things. It is not a conversation that a lot of Black women, for example, are willing to have. It's scary because you see the same spirit with some of the Black men who are going to go down the conservative side Republican just because. And the overall rhetoric, spirit of it, whatever, is I'm going to exploit myself simply for the sake of getting out of the situation. And I covered the Django and Chain, and I talked about Stefan. And in that movie, spiritually, there's a fight through the writing. I'm saying spiritually, as in related to try to overgeneralize, but spiritually, there's a fight between Stefan, who has submitted to those ways, has learned how to work his way through that type of environment and setting and get to the top, and he's comfortable with the racism because now he's on top. Versus the Django who fights and is able to fight for his freedom. So there is a battle there. That's why Stefan is the bigger villain compared to someone like whatever likes of a white owner of Candyland that was played by Leo DiCaprio. And I noticed that. And what I'm going to continue to tackle with this whole Hollywood thing is that despite the strides in the past that Black people have made and done to try to work with not only other movements, but other people in general, it doesn't matter because it's not a real compromise. It doesn't matter what work we've done in the past because the people on the other side have always set up the game so that they can use and break Black people. And they take a break. They give Black people a break, and then they use other races. But notice the rhetoric difference. When they use races that they have in slavery, then those other races are quick to think, oh, Black people are just lazy. No, we just don't want to get used again. No, we just don't want to be manipulated again. Did you think about that? Did you think about we're in the same country where we were enslaved? I mean, how stupid is it? Look, Black people are compared to both Jews and Native Americans. But the bigger difference is the Jews were not only allowed to accept that slavery happened, they were able to build up from it. But one of the bigger differences, they did move from a country where all that manipulation happened. Native Americans were in the same country. They got the reparations. But at the end of the day, keeping it 100%, most Black people do not, they don't, we have not really recovered from the damage that has happened. And we have not been allowed to have a culture. And it'd be one thing if this had just happened to Black people, but it did not. Similar to what happened with Black people, it happened to Native Americans where they tried to indoctrinate them into their lives to cause more same on same violence. But yeah, all of you want to do, I'm going to talk about this more, especially when it comes to Hollywood, because yeah, I did, in the past, we did shoulder the burden of dating out this and the other and try to give it a really good perspective. But, it does play the sound. I don't know what was happening the first time, it was not playing the sound. Oh, thank you. I don't get what it was. That would be a review, and he would highlight what was the big conversation. Yep.
Well, you heard it here first, guys. Let's go to commercial.